Hey guys, Brandon here, and welcome to my studio tour for 2017. Well, maybe it's more of an update video than an actual tour. After this video, if you haven't seen that 2015 video, you can go check it out and see what how it compares. The most notable change in 2017 that I have are my monitor stands. Got these last year. So instead of them being on the desk on foam pads, they're actually, you know, more separated away from each other. So you've got more of a true stereo image, just independent of each other. It just helps clear the sound up. It's not so boomy. You wouldn't think they're stable, but they really are. They're literally just sitting there and they don't move. I noticed immediately whenever I put some music on, I'm like, wow, it just cleared up everything. They sound just so clear. The only thing I guess I could add is to get rid of this echoiness that you probably don't really hear because I'm talking straight into a mounted Rode mic, so you wouldn't hear it otherwise, but I guess you could get like an area rug or, you know, like a floor. It covers most of the room. That way it gets rid of the echoiness. And then the next change that is more notable is I was watching my old video. I was amazed. I was like, oh yeah, wow. This is my vocal booth. So this closet still looked like much like a closet. And I had this blue quilt thing just kind of hanging on a metal pole. And everything else was exposed. The sound is very much more dead in here, so that's much more of a vocal booth that you'd want. The only thing exposed is this wall back behind here, so that's really the only thing. Everything else is pretty much covered by a quilt. Well, of course, the ceiling is not too. And then, you know, sound can go up over that and stuff, but it's a whole lot more dead of a sound in here than before. And by the way, this mic is not mine. This is my vocalist's. It's a Sterling Audio ST55, the reason I have this in here is because he doesn't have an interface at his place, and so we decided, since we're recording here anyway, he's like, well, I'll just bring mine over here and you just leave it at your house. I was like, okay, that's cool. And I asked him, I said, well, can I just use it for my stuff too? That way I can just keep it in here, because I kind of sometimes move mine around, this AKG, and so it's kind of nice to have maybe his in the same spot all the time, and then I'll have mine maybe as like a podcast type of microphone. You know, like if I'm doing tutorials, it'll be there sitting there for me. Now for my videos, I typically will be using my Rode mountable mic that I just recently got from my DSLR that I mentioned. I'd like to upgrade that also yet again because I got the non-pro version and did not remember having used it previously in another job. How much mic hiss you have. So I've got a plugin that helps clean up that stuff, but it would still be nice to have. So board notes. This is still the same function as usual, except now lately I've been using it to remind me of videos that I need to edit. So that helps me because I've recently been trying to make my videos ahead of time. So I did change my mind about buying a 57 microphone to amp this. I don't really use this amp much. I've thought about kind of maybe selling it and get a different one. I've done this a lot, you know, but I don't really like the sound of it anymore. And besides, I really record everything in my computer now, so really don't need this much. So anyway, we'll see what happens. I've had minor changes with the posters on the wall. Looking back at my other video, the only thing I really added on this side is gonna be Paul Wardingham's almost latest album. It's the one before the Spiritual Machines that he did. This is the Human Affliction one. These are the same. And the only thing I changed here, Fit for a King, their group photo, I think, is on the back of this one. So I just basically flipped the poster to have their album on here. I didn't have the Era Drift poster. For a time, I had it sitting over my studio computer area, but after I found this at my local store, I was like, okay, that is a much better statement, and that just is kind of a nice focal point of the room. Like, oh yeah, there we go, it's perfect. And it's a much bigger poster too, so that's really the only thing that's changed here. That skillet poster's been there ever since I moved in, and as you can see, I think it has, but anyway. As you can see, I, of course, since I got the monitor stands, I did have to move, this guitar rack you know, from there to there. So it's the same guitars, you know, same interface as last time. I still haven't upgraded it, just don't have the money to do it. Of course, the same monitors. Pretty much every other equipment that's in here is the same as it has been in 2015 studio tour. So definitely check that out if you haven't already, and you can get more explanation on what I actually use. New tripod. I just needed a new one because the swivel wasn't tight anymore, and so like my camera would just fall forward. And the camera wouldn't fall, but it wouldn't stay level. It was annoying. It was like basically rendered useless after a while. I can't remember if this was the same way last time, but I used this as my soft light. and so I'll usually angle it like off axis like that. And so it's sitting, you know, just I'll just position this wherever, you know, in the room. So like I might have that sitting there like that. And, you know, this is just kind of, you know, bounces off the ceiling and just have basically all my lights on. And then I'll set my white balance to tungsten style on my camera, especially if I'm recording in the daytime. So that way, if I use auto, it doesn't get confused with the daytime light. It could be possibly sort of bleeding through just a little bit with the ceiling light on and that light on and then this light on. It usually gives a pretty balanced look, sort of. You might be wondering, well, why don't you just, you know, upgrade to a normal lighting? Well, one is space. I'd have to kind of change my space stuff. This isn't really a much really large room. It's not that large. I just don't want it to be real crowded in here. I don't like feeling claustrophobic. So that would have to change, and we'll have to get, you know, the finances to do that too. Maybe if I get another job, I'll have that ability. Also run some cool contests for you guys. I definitely plan to have that change soon. So anyway, guys, I guess that's probably all. There's not really anything else to show you that you would not have already seen in 2015. So thank you guys so much for watching, and peace out.